Here is an example of how to create and call a sub-procedure. In the Excel workbook on Sheet 1, the number 3 is in cell B2 and the number 5 is in cell B3. We want to develop a macro that will calculate the difference and product of these two numbers and display the results in cells B5 and B6. Here's an example of one way to accomplish this task. In our macro named math, we start by declaring num1, num2, diff, and prod as double variables. Num1 and num2 will store the values in cells B2 and B3. Diff and prod will store the difference and product of those two values. These four variables are initially assigned the value 0. We then select sheet 1, and cell B2 becomes the active cell. The value in cell B2, which is 3, is assigned to num1. The active cell is moved 1 row and 0 columns, and the active cell is now B3. The value in cell B3, which is 5, is assigned to num2. At this point, the values stored in num1, num2, diff, and prod are 3, 5, 0, and 0, and these are displayed to the user in a message box. The difference between num1 and num2 is 3 minus 5 or negative 2, and this is assigned to diff. Prod now contains the value 3 times 5, which is 15. The values that are stored in num1, num2, diff, and prod are 3, 5, negative 2, and 15, and these are displayed to the user in another message box. The active cell is then moved 2 rows and 0 columns and is now cell B5. The value of diff, which is negative 2, is assigned to that cell. The active cell is then moved 1 row and 0 columns and is now cell B6. The value of prod, which is 15, is assigned to that cell. Here I've created a run button for the macro math. After clicking this button, the first message box states 3500. The second message box states 3, 5, -2, 15. And the values negative 2 and 15 appear in cells B5 and B6, just as we predicted. Now we will modify our macro so that the difference and product will be calculated in a separate sub-procedure. The code shown here will produce the exact same results as the previous version of the code. Everything between the statements option explicit and call calc DP are the same. We obtain values from cells B2 and B3 and assign them to the values num1 and num2. And a message box will display the current values stored in num1, num2, diff, and prod, which are 3, 5, 0, and 0. Next, the sub-procedure named calc DP is called. Calc DP is short for calculate difference in product. I chose this name because it is short and descriptive, but the program would have worked equally well had I chosen any name for the sub-procedure. Calc DP contains 4 arguments, num1, num2, diff, and prod. At this point in the code, the sub-procedure math halts and waits until calc DP is completed. The sub-procedure calc DP is written after the sub-procedure math is terminated by n sub. Procedures communicate to one another through their argument lists. When the subprocedure calc DP is called in the subprocedure math, the variables num1, num2, diff, and prod are passed down from math to the variables in calc DP's argument list. The first argument in the calling statement list is linked with the first argument in calcdp. The second argument in the calling statement list is linked with the second argument in the calcdp list. The third argument in the calling statement list is linked with the third argument in calcdp, and the fourth argument in the calling statement argument list is linked with the fourth argument in calcdp. This means that num1 in math and num1 in calcdp are linked together. Any changes made to num1 in calcdp will affect num1 in math. Similarly, num2 in math and num2 in calcdp are linked together. Any changes made to num2 in calcdp will affect num2 in math. Diff in math and diff in calcdp are linked together. Any changes made to diff in calcdp will affect diff in math. And finally, prod in math and prod in calcdp are linked together. Any changes made to prod in calcdp will affect prod in math. Although the argument names in both argument lists are the same in this example, num1, num1, num2, num2, diff and diff, prod and prod, in general, the argument names may be different. However, the number of arguments in both argument lists must be the same. In this case, there are four arguments in both lists. Notice how the variables num1, num2, diff, and prod are not declared in the subprocedure calcdp. This is because all variables in calcdp's argument lists are automatically declared when calcdp begins. These variables are given the data types of the arguments in the calling statement list, which are all double. Inside the subprocedure calcdp, the value of num1 minus num2, which is negative 2, is assigned to diff. Next, the value num1 times num2, which is 15, is assigned to prod. We have reached the end of the subprocedure calcdp, and we return to the subprocedure math. Remember that each argument in the calling statement list is linked with the corresponding argument in calcdp's argument list. The value of the first argument in calcdp, that is the value of num1, is passed up to the first argument in the calling statement, which is also named num1. Num1 in calcdp is 3, so num1 in the subprocedure math also remains 3. The value of the second argument in calcdp, which is named num2, is passed back up to the second argument in the calling statement, which is also named num2. Num2 in calcdp is 5, so num2 in math remains 5. The value of the third argument in calcdp, which is diff, is passed back up to the third argument in the calling statement, which is also named diff. Diff in calcdp has the value negative 2. So diff in math now has the value of negative 2. The value of the fourth argument in calcdp, which is named prod, is passed back up to the fourth argument in the calling statement, which is also named prod. Prod in calcdp has the value 15. So prod in the subprocedure math also now is 15. The message box following the call statement states that the values of num1 and num2 are 3 and 5, but diff and prod now are negative 2 and 15. Finally, the values of diff and prod are assigned to cells B5 and B6. When the run button is clicked, we obtain the expected results. 3500, 35 negative 2 15, and negative 2 15. This was a relatively simple example. As you develop more computer programming skills and your programs become more complicated, the need to make your programs modular will become more apparent.